Leslie was an icon in the DC women's movement when I was a young woman, and she lent her tremendous street cred to me as I maneuvered the building trades. I was one of the rare straight women in the building trades back then, and Leslie lent her street cred to me. And whenever she came to DC, it was hard. You had to elbow in to get to see her because she was so popular and wonderful. But she was all, people have mentioned also that she's a leader in the anti-racism movement, and it meant a lot to me. And when I was a young woman, I was quick to call somebody racist who was insensitive or backward on the national question. And then recently, I lived up here in the East Side, Lower East Side of New York, and I was up here when the Trayvon Martin verdict came down. And my roommate was a progressive white man. He's the leadership of another movement, and they do a lot of work on Bradley Manning and stuff like that. So he's a good progressive guy. And his day job, he's on Wall Street, so you know he had that side of him too. But my eldest son was up here visiting me, and the verdict came down. I was really angry and frustrated. And you know, my roommate came home. He said, "Let me put on my bike. I'll go with you guys," because we figured there was going to be a march in Union Square, and there was one. And I was angry, and we're coming back, and just frustrated, you know, because I have two sons and have to worry about them encountering police. And when we got home to the apartment, my friend, he listened to me complain for like 4 or 5 solid hours. And then when my son went to lay down, he said, "You know, Pam, there's not much the jury could have come up with. There's no other conclusion they could have come to given the circumstances and the information they had to work with." And so, and I'm related to my son, and he was like, "Well, he's a white guy, you know, what are you gonna do, you know?" But instead of, I realized that instead of the anger that I felt as a young person, I was just really disappointed that after all these years, you know, there's still people who've been in the movement their whole lives and just don't get it. And in my mind immediately went to Leslie, because Leslie got it. And just like a patient, counselor, supportive, not dismissive, not patronizing in any way, but just a defender of other oppressed people. And that's how you win allies. And really had a lot of respect for her. My condolences.
I wish I knew how it would feel to be free. I wish I could break all the chains holding me. I wish I could say all the things that I should say. See, I'm loud, see, I'm clear for the whole wide world to hear. I wish I could share all the love in my heart. Remove all that keep us apart. I wish you could know how it feels to be me. Then you'd see and agree that everyone should be free. I wish I could give longing to give. I wish I could live like I'm longing to live. I wish I could do all the things that I can do, though I'm way overdue. bird in the sky. How sweet it would be if I found I could fly. I'd soar to the sun and look down at the sea. And I'd say, 'cause I know. I'd sing 'cause I know. I'd sing 'cause I know how it feels to be free.